My name is Grace. Today I'm going to read two stories. Run, Rabbit, Run. And The Inch Prince. Today I'm going to read this first. This is very story. Actually, I was just looking for anything and I found this in the top. So I am going to read this. It's a short one, but I'll read. And this is just, it is not too long. I spot 6 crows in the park today. Play on the train with us, they said. Stay away. I think they're saying just like that because they will eat her, okay? And the mouse is saying, stay away. Join us for a feast. Beneath the tree. I can see no meat. Do they mean me? Better not wait and see. She's saying like that to her. I see 7 volunteers high in the sky. Can you fly? We will help you try. That's a lie. The snail is saying that's a lie. They all thinking with the rabbit is pie. Jump in our boat. We will go for a row. Slow and so slow, just dip in your toe. No, 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 the frog is saying like that. And they're saying to come in the boat because they're trying to eat. 3 sharks swim in the new blue pool. The sun is hot, you can keep cool. Sure, I said, say, I am not such a fool. Yes, this is finished. And I will read this story, The Inch Prince. Once upon a time, there was a little old man and a little old woman. Their name were Mr. and Mrs. Pink. They lived in a tiny house by a river. every day they needed the plants in their vegetable pot. The beans look beautiful. Feed the animal in their field. The hens look happy. And water the flower in their garden. The lice look lovely. They had everything they wanted. Well, almost. I wish we had some children, said Mrs. Pink. One evening, only a tiny children could fit in our tiny house, said Mr. Pink sadly. But small things can be special too, said his wife. I couldn't care if they were just all 1 inch tall, she added. At that moment, a fairy fly by. She heard what Mr. and Mrs. Bing said. She noted their lovely vegetables, happy animal, and tall flowers. These people are kind, thought the fairy. I will be kind to them. She waved her wand and whispered some magic words. Jumping beans and flying fish give these flock their bitterest wish. This is the word. Soon afterwards, Mr. and Mrs. Ping had a teeny weeny boy. In fact, he was just 1 inch tall. Let's call him Isan Bushi, said Mrs. Ping. It means 1 inch boy. Or Lassie for short, said her husband. Very short. There's the boy is so small. Each year, the Ping's vegetable grew better. Their animal grew better, and their flowers grew taller. But instantly, stayed small. It's hard. Maybe if I stand on tiptoe, he he's very small, isn't it? And he's 5 years old. Easy was tiny. He had a bottle for a bathtub. He had a skull for a scarf. He had a pea for a ball. Goal. He had a button for a dinner plate. And he had a matchbox for a bed. He's very tiny. Many years later, it was time for Lassie to leave home. I will get a job in the city. His parents gave him 3 pence for his job. He had a rice ball for a boat. He had a pair of chopsticks for oats. And he had the needle for a saw. Oh, he's so cute. Issy set off down the river between tall mountains, paths, village, around wide woods and through the town until he reached by the city. First he was there and he's going here. He's also here. He's also here and he's also here. And he's also here. I will ask the emperor for a job, thought Issy. That's if I don't get squished first. At last, Issy reached the emperor's palace. 2 guards were marching up and down outside. I did like a job. I do like a job. I want a job, said Issy. Are you tiny? Said one guard. What can you do? I can run past you for a stretch. Where did he go? He jumped over the garden's foot and ran into the palace. He's running. A cook was making dinner. I like a job. Said Issy. Why are you tiny? Said the cook. What can you do? I can run past you for a stretch. Start. Issy said, hey, where did you go? He ran around the cook's oven into the next room. Incy was in the tall room. He bowed to the emperor and the princess. I want a job, please, Your Majesty, said Incy. His tiny weeny daddy, said Prince. Chichi, what can I do? What can he do? Well, I ran past you, your garden, and mine and your cook to get here, said Incy. The emperor thought for a moment. You can look after Princess Chichi, she said. He said, but Daddy, wanted the princess. He's only 1 inch tall. Small thing can be special too, said the emperor. From then on, Incy never left the princess said. He was there in the afternoon. He was there in at the night. One day, the prince left the palace to visit her aunt. Incy went too. They came to a dark forest. I am scared, said the prince, Chichi. I will look after you, said Incy. What can you do? Said the prince. Just then, there was a terrifying roar. Help! Gigantic ogre crashed it through the trees. He reached to a rope at the princess. Grab that princess. Just a silly monster. Put her down, said Incy, or I will. You, said the ogre. What can you do? The ogre scooped up Incy and popped him in his mouth. Yum, I love bit six snakes. Incy saw quickly. He took his needle sword unpick the organ's tongue. Take that. Ooh. The orc spat out Issy and run out. That will teach him. Thank you, Issy. Look, said Issy. The orger left his hammer behind. The princess took the pick it up. The princess tried to pick it up, but it was too heavy. Woo! It's heavier than it looks. I wish you were bigger, Issy, she said. Then maybe you could lift it. A coat of magical start short out the hammer and swept around Issy. Issy felt himself changing. He grew bigger and bigger and bigger. In a second, he was as big as the princess. I am as tall as you, said Issy. The hammer granted your wish. The prince fell in love with Issy. But not because he was tall. She loved him because he was brave. They got married and lived in a house next to the palace. Their house was small, but Prince Issy and Princess Chichi was very happy. They both knew that small things can be special too. Finish. Yes, today I read two stories, Run Rabbit Run and The Inchel Prince. It was fun then, bye.